Ferrari. It's one of our ladders that we have, or truck that we have here. We have a 100-foot stick up here. It's equipped, so we carry water on this truck as well. We have all kinds of things in different departments. Here's where we keep our toolkit. If you ever need any tools or stuff like that for minor things. Back in the cab, we keep all of our other tools. We carry a set of irons here. The two positions we have on the truck are the guy that's hooking the can and then the guy that's on the irons. So irons is just flathead axe and hound. And then we have the hook here. Here we have all the air packs that we keep. Here we have an extra jump kit if we need that. Inside the truck, we carry a Scott pack finder. They're just programmed to our air packs. And then we have a thermal imaging camera. A couple flashlights that we need in case we use them. And then back here, we never really use them unless we absolutely have to, but we carry hose lines on this truck. This truck's primary job is, this is the frontline truck to any structure fire that we have, and the engine is the one where we pull the lines off of, but we absolutely have to pull lines off of this truck. These small compartments right here, we carry small, well not small, well small compartments, we carry these bottles here, just extra ones, so when we use the ones that
oxygen.
Are on our backs.
Yep.
We carry, well it's just breathing air, so these are all just, these are 45 minute bottles compared to 30 minute bottles. I think they make like three different kinds, they're like 30, 45 in an hour. Hour ones are more for like RIT and hazmat, and we're all switching to 45 minute ones. This compartment right here, we just carry even more of them. So if we have a lot of other guys that come in on callbacks or stuff like that, they'll go through and have more bottles for them. This side over here, we have a couple high rises in this department, in our district. So because of that, we carry these things right here. High rise pack, it's a single jacketed inch and three quarter. Hooks right up to a high rise connection and you run a smooth bore nozzle. Then, we have a Y connector board as well. Extra water can, those are really great to use, especially with high rises. This compartment right here is a chimney kit. We'll have chimney fires, extra small tool kit, water, especially on days like today where it's over 90 degrees, it's really good to have water. Here we have a door spreader, a couple of other extra tools, closet hooks, extra here. Axe, wheel chocks, Italian bar, and again, all this stuff is chimney fire stuff. Something that's pretty interesting that our captain did on this truck when they designed it, was the captain that you spoke to earlier. Yeah. They put this on this truck, so when we get to the back, I'll show you the ladders, but this is if somebody parks behind our truck here, we need to get a 24-foot ladder. We don't have to worry about somebody being parked behind us and not able to pull out a 24-foot ladder.
Oh.
So, you pick that up off of guys. I think it's awesome that do that. And here is all of our positive pressure vents. So we have positive pressure fan, negative pressure fan. Actually, not sure if it's two. And then we have our RIT packs. So we carry two different types of RIT packs. This is one of them, which just carries the regular pack itself. Inside of it, we have an extra mask. So firefighter's mask is messed up, we can use that. And then here we carry the connector and turn on the bottle and stuff. Here we carry the other RIT pack. Same stuff, it just carries more stuff with it. We're more likely to go to this RIT pack if we have to grab it because we have side compartments here, webbing to drag out a firefighter. Wow. And there's more webbing to drag out a firefighter. Here we have ropes, rope bags. These are what we use if we do go into a RIT situation. Firefighter will grab the RIT bag, they'll throw this on themselves, and then say myself and the firefighter there go into a fire together. He'll grab this right here, we call them dog leashes. It'll be hooked up to him, and this will hook up to me, or this will hook onto him. And he can go a certain distance and he can find his way back to me. This is also for like large area searches, so if there's like a huge department store and we have to go through it, then these are really great. You just tie this off to a post or a known point, and you can follow your way back to it. And that's actually pretty light. Then put the tarp right here. blunt saws. So here's a Husqvarna caped wolf saw. We use this just for any type of venting. This blade right here will go through a lot of roofs, things of that nature. Keep a flashlight on it so you can see. We have just a regular chainsaw here, it's just to cut trees and stuff. We have to. Back here, like I said earlier, we talked about how that ladder up there.
Yeah.
So if somebody parks behind us, so a lot of these times we have other mutual aid communities that come to us. They can kind of park close to these trucks, and if we need to grab a ladder right off the bat, and I go pull this 24-foot ladder, that's going to go out quite a distance.
Yeah.
We're not able to get them out. So that's the perk of having that 24 right there. Here we carry 35, 16. We've had an attic ladder here. It's probably, I think, up on the top right now. Here we carry LDH because this truck does full water. On this truck we keep this right here is for the underneath of it to kind of make sure the guy that's in his bucket, if he's on top of a building, he's not cooking. We keep all the hose and stuff, hydro bag back there as well. Right here we keep a Stokes basket and extra hooks. So that on in there. We have these extra hooks though for any type of roof work that we have. So if we're on a roof and we need to kind of start poking holes for venting, we have all that stuff there. We keep these regular hooks here, New York hooks there. Inside of the truck, we just keep extra hose and electrical stuff. This right here is a generator, so if we need to plug in any saws, we're good to go there. Here we keep our ladder belts and water cans and extinguishers that we carry. So if we need to go up in the bucket for any type of work there, we're supposed to be wearing ladder belts and we just grab our ladder belts. And here, we keep for any type of overhaul that we do after building's been put out. There's going to be a lot of water damage or any type of water calls. We'll grab these right here. These vacuums are specifically made to suck up water and then we just dump them right out. And here we just carry a bunch of extra tools, bolt cutters here, axe there, sledgehammer, axe, set of irons, and a lapel again. Up here we carry a vent saw. I'll get up there and show you that. We also carry extra ladders on this truck as well. So we have a lot of this. Ready for it. And then the vent saw. This is the vent saw we more commonly use over the K12 saw. And that just sits right in there like that. Extra air packs, so guys that are not working on shift but coming on a day off, if there's a structure fire or any of our call guys, they can grab those air packs and we're good to go. Just like on the other side, we have the two compartments for extra bottles. This right here is what we call an engineer's compartment. If they have to do any type of pumping off this truck, they're just different connections to bring a 5-inch line, which is going into a hydrant, to inch 3/4 line. Different types of connections to fill the trucks or put water off the trucks. We carry extra nozzles as well. Like here we have an adjustable gallonage fog nozzle. We recently got smoothbore nozzles on our attack trucks as well, which is nice. And then here's just another side for these. These are regularly just straight loaded. Pull them off and they're good to go. So what we do is we grab the pigtail, yard it off, twist it or not twist it, depends on who's using it, and just go with it, bring it to the fire. It's the pump panel. This department is a career department and a per diem department. So the career guys will be ones that are allowed to pump the trucks and drive the trucks. I'm a per diem, so we don't pump or drive the trucks. We just work off of the trucks. Here we carry an extra side, a length of 2-inch. That's more for defensive work, pretty rarely used for interior work. Over here is how we use to set the truck, so all these knobs and stuff here. Bring out the jacks, lower all the jacks, and get the truck level enough so we can work off it.